And we are live from Killadelphia, said to be a city of firsts. And the first time I saw a spinal cord wrapped around a goalpost was right here at Too Big to Fail Financial Stadium. The teams are juiced up and ready for blood as they take the field for MFL action. The Blitzburgh Steelheads battle the Killadelphia Eagles. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. It's time to turn on, tune in, and get your mutant buzz on. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow here. It's MFL Game Day, and you know what that means.
Yeah, the town will be in flames tonight, and half the city's population will be sliding down greased street poles and eating all-you-can-eat horseshit buffets from the curb.
Yes, victory can be bittersweet sometimes, Bricks. Let's see if the home team can light up this town like a Roman candle. And it's first and 10. Gonna shave a few days off his life. And it's first and 10. And the quarterback finds his man for the first down. And it's first and 10. Second down and long. Defense just called the ginormous dirty trick.
His big ass will probably show up on the...
It's a touchdown! I think they're showing my cards. It's hot till midnight. Yeah. They'll check my card another one night.
And they line up for the extra point. Straight through the uprights.
I think I showed my cards. It's at the midnight.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm Threads. Their marketing team hates it.
And it's first and 10.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
That's a pass and catch for no gain.
Then how is it a pass?
Third and 4. And the bomb goes off, hurting no one.
Yeah, if a bomb don't kill anyone, does it still make a sound?
Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
And he got it off. That's a decent punt. He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it. Oh, that's a vicious hit. And the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutant meat.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. That ball just sliced through the defense like butter.
I wish defenses were made out of butter. That'd be fantastic.
That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. And it's first and ten. Oh, big catch! Big run! Big touchdown!
And big deal. Missed a beat for Brace having a ball didn't fall out.
Here, just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
First and ten. This is your brain, and this is, and they stack the line, and he gets his bell rung for a yard. Second down and nine. And an 8-yard gain on that one.
Like when Brix's mom decided to move back in with us.
Down and a pussy here. He took a beef boost injection. Now wants him stop all over his opponents.
I want to take a beef boost injection too.
Now that has weird side effects, Brix. And with a burst of speed, he finds an opening and the first down. Does anyone have a rule book? Because that sounds like he's making stuff up.
Chance he can reach the table without spilling your food, idiot.
Third down and 10, and they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref. And the ref runs out of bounds and manages to survive somehow.
Yeah, at least for another 40 seconds.
Third down and long. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Third down and the QB is saying his prayers. Stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. And he put all of his foot into that one. He's got the ball now and is going to try and score.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
And it's first and ten. That's a nice gain of about 7 yards on that run. Second and three. And he's able to grab that one somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the third set of hands he's had shown on today. Looks like it's a good fit.
Call that about a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Brix.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation.
That's the end of quarter one. Well, the good news is there's still time to make it a game.
And there's still time to get a beer.
First down and one. Trying to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It's good. I think I showed my confidence. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chimp wearing a wig.
Running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch.
And he put the jets on and caught him from behind. And it's first and ten. Well, 1 yard is better than nothing, but not by much. Second down and nine. Quarterback passes for a touchdown. When skeletons make it to the end zone in one piece, that's always cause for celebration. The extra point attempt. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
First and ten. Second down and a lot. He broke free and has open field in front of him. Here comes the defense. He's at the 10.
Goal!
You ever do that again, Bricks, I'll shoot you in the head.
Well, people like it.
Here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. Straight through the uprights. I think I showed my confidence. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. He's gonna be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
First and ten. No, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole. so up here talking to you.
Third down and forever. He's not going down. And he snatches that one out of the air for a first down. See if they can get something going here. First and 10. Great run for a 9-yard gain. And that'll bring up second and 1.
Murphy Brown!
What?
I mean, first down!
What the hell was that? And he catches it for a touchdown. What a beautiful play.
Yeah, it's almost poetic, Green. Like a haiku.
Well, this should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. Goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
Because if you can't answer your question with and the defense calls the thunderclap dirty trick, man, that's gotta hurt.
That'll make the hair on your corpse stand straight up.
The 20. The 10. Touchdown! Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. First and 10. Man, he shoveled his feet so well on that play. He should go to lost wages and deal cards. First down! And it's first and 10. Smart move there, stopping the clock with their first time out.
And for all you know, maybe he's just stalling or wiring the ref some cash.
And it's first and 10. And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. the first, and the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. First down and forever. They've got one more timeout left, but they've stopped the clock.
Why don't they just take the batteries out of the clock, Grim? That would make more sense.
Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. Blasted and picks up 7 yards right there. And they take their last time out.
It's between them and the clock now, Grim.
Well, and the defense, too. Third down and never gonna happen. Well, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole.
And they'll line up for the punt here. He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get a return. And he's got a chance for a good return here. Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're gonna hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor.
Finish him.
And it's first and 10. Catch will give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set.
And they quickly call a timeout to stop the clock. And this is going to be a rocket shot to the moon. Straight through the uprights. They need a good return here to set up the offense. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, Bricks. It means he can return it for, you know what? Never mind. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. And it's first and 10. Close battle as the quarter ends. Halftime is brought to you by those caring folks at Monsanto Industries. They make the world a better place by making the government tell you it is. It's anyone's game as the third quarter begins. Both teams have taken their performance-enhancing drugs, and everyone is ready to rock and roll. The teams line up for the second half kickoff. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. And it's first and 10. And he just used his beast boost dirty trick, and there's no way to stop him. Of course, you'd kill him.
Oh, look at that freak go. He's unstoppable.
Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice, Grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
And it's first and 10. Killer, it was right there, and then he dropped it.
Oh, is killing me in the fantasy league.
Second down and 10. Almost broke that one wide open.
Hey, speaking of breaking one wide open, who's sitting on the oil rig about to blow? Hey, smells like an oven baked portage on it here. We're a freaking fracking accident waiting to happen. Don't nobody light a match.
Here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on the air. And he just lets that one go. He says, no, thank you, and the defense downs it. And it's first and 10. Down. See if they can get something going here. And it's first and 10. That's a gain of 7 yards on the catch. Nicely done. Second and 3. Opens up for them and allows the passing game to be more of a threat. Gotta keep them guessing. And it's first and 10. And he held on to that one for a first down. And it's first and 10. Mix of tiger blood, shark blood, and internet comments. Roid rage. No one was interested in that incomplete pass.
Not a ball's feelings are hurt.
Hey, don't make me explain that balls don't have emotions again, all right? Second down and 10. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sinners then.
It's good. I think I showed my confidence. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! Man, what a hit that was! And it's first and 10. His way out of that tackle. And that hit jars the ball loose, and it's a fumble. That's what happens when you hurdle and take a hard hit. And it's first and 10. Second down in a very lot. The defense better watch out. The quarterback just threw a murder ball.
I left it, Mike.
First down. it's first and 10. That, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. And it's first and 10. He was starting to go somewhere, but he gets stumped after three.
They usually stop me after three, too. You know, the all-you-can-eat buffets? They're not as literal as you'd think.
Second down and 7.
Oh, man, he really wants it.
Catch the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. And it's first and 10. And that brings us to the end of the third quarter. They'll need to fire on all cylinders to make a comeback in the final quarter. Second down and more than the QB would like. Oh, big catch, big run, big touchdown.
And big deal, Mr. Beat for Brains having a ball and fall out.
They're going for two.
Yeah, they got big balls, Grim.
Yeah, bigger than yours.
And the defense stops him cold. That play just got blown to hell.
Yeah, he got blown to shit. Speaking of blow, where'd my little clap?
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. They're going to be able to return this one. Welcome to Fumbletown, USA. Population, this guy. Well, he should be more careful when he hurdles. And it's first and 10. And that catch will give them a first down.
But he sure has a good set of hands.
And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
Bounced away. The defense has to do a better job of watching out for that dirty trick. Second down and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 yards on that play. Third down and 5.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
And that is caught for a first down. Nice pickup for 6 yards. And that'll be second down and 4. That would have been a disappointing run. It's even a worse throw. Third down and 3. scores handily. Well, why go for one when you could go for two?
It's always been my philosophy, but Bricks can't even get one. Oh, you're talking about points.
No one was going to stop him. That's 2 points. When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and 10. Run it for a couple of yards. And that'll be 2nd and 8 to go. Oh, with a brutal hit. Third down, and the punter is warming up.
I personally think the ginormous guy is compensating for something, but I won't be the one to tell him.
And the quarterback finds his man for the first down. And it's 1st and 10. And that's how you shock the monkey. Thunderclap. I bet you took a lot of shots like that. These penalties have really gotten out of hand, especially since they're fake.
Go to dirty tricks and hit the tag ref. It feels good.
They're back up here on first, and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. First down in a mile. Oh, the receiver has to make that catch. Now he put the team in a hole. 2nd down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. And they went to the air and came up big. And that'll bring up 3rd down and 7. Only 2 minutes left in the game. And that'll bring up 3rd down and 7. They are, but sometimes the defense thinks they're helping out in their own special way. And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross-stitching, unbelievable.
And he's snags the punt and looks for open. Oh, mama! He just knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
And it's first and ten. Not much there, maybe a yard. They use their second timeout, but they are running out of time.
A bit pessimistic, don't you think so, Grim?
It's more about building tension, Bricks. That's all we do at this point. And drink this bourbon. Come on, give me that. You can tell he's a berserker because he's dropping at the mouth.
Oh, that guy? Oh, is it that one?
He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb. First and ten. He runs it for three. And that's the last timeout. The D has to either break the clock or the offense if they want to win.
As long as something gets broke, right?
Second down and seven. Oh, with a punishing hit. And that'll bring up third down and seven.
Oh, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Graham.
And it's first and ten. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's going to have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. Second down and long.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
It's the Eagles declaring victory today.
Well, looks like I'm declaring bankruptcy. I've been on the wrong team again.
The entire game was trench warfare. Both teams battling back and forth, bruised and battered, but in the end, there could be only one winner.
There are winners in my book. I think that a defeated team should get a participation award because, yeah, I tried really hard.
Why don't you try real hard to shut the fuck up?
Nice mouth. Why don't you try to lay off the scotch, Junior?
Suck on it.
Real nice. Let's go to the game's MVP.
Hey, man. See that? That's right. You can't handle this. You can't handle what I got. Yeah, get the hell out of here, man.
Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it so you...